This is the Apogee Chlorophyll Concentration Meter, and if you want to monitor your plant's health, then this is an incredibly handy tool. Simply put, a greener plant is a healthier plant, and that greenness is created by the amount of chlorophyll in the leaves. Chlorophyll is responsible for turning H2O and CO2 into glucose, or the food that a plant needs. The more chlorophyll a plant has, the more food a plant gets, and that means happier, healthier plants. Extracting and measuring chlorophyll used to be an incredibly expensive and time-consuming process. Not to mention, punching holes in a plant's leaves is super destructive to a plant's health. Now, if you want to learn more about the technical science behind how this meter works and how we were able to convert the greenness of a plant into quantifiable chlorophyll, then watch this video. It goes into detail about creating the reference indexes that are used in this meter. If you don't want to watch that video, just know that essentially this meter measures the greenness of a plant and then converts that number into a specific index equation, giving you a chlorophyll concentration amount. So how does tracking chlorophyll help you? By knowing the chlorophyll concentration amount, you can begin to track your plant's health. As you start tracking chlorophyll, over time, you'll start to see trends emerge. For example, as you see the plant start to grow, you'll see the chlorophyll amount start to increase. The chlorophyll will start to rise until it reaches its maximum chlorophyll levels, or the ideal amount. Now, this ideal amount is different for every species. All the time, we get people asking, what's the ideal chlorophyll amount for my plant? Well, the truth is, it depends. That ideal chlorophyll amount is actually determined by you. By measuring your crops over time, you'll start to understand how much chlorophyll is typically in your plant. But through testing, you might be able to push those levels up a little bit. Now keep in mind, measuring chlorophyll is like taking your body temperature. When your body temperature goes up or down, really it's only telling you that something is wrong. It won't specifically say what is causing the problem. It only indicates that you're not as healthy as you normally are. And that's similar to how a chlorophyll concentration meter will work. It won't tell you exactly what's happening with your plants, just that the health is increasing or decreasing. Over time, you might start to notice a fade or a dip in the chlorophyll concentration levels. This could indicate something like a nitrogen deficiency, water stress, or other factor that's influencing your plant's health. In a similar way, you could test two different kinds of fertilizer, and you might see the rise or fall of specific plants that you tested. You might not see the subtle changes with your eye, but that's why we've created this meter. This comes in extremely helpful if you want to monitor your plant's health for testing or for maximizing a plant's health for crop production. Either way, this tool can be worth its weight in gold. All right, let's take a brand new meter, and I'll show you what's inside the box. As we open the box, we'll see we have our chlorophyll concentration meter, a 9-volt battery, a USB cable, and some sensor area reducers. These sensor reducers come in really handy if you're trying to measure a leaf that's really small. And we'll talk more about that in just a little bit. So let's pull the meter out of the box, take the cover off the back by pushing it down and sliding it down. Take the battery and do the large terminal on the large pad and the small terminal on the small pad. Stick the bottom in first and push it in. Put the cover on the back and slide it up and lock it in place. It should turn on automatically. If it doesn't, press the power button in the bottom right corner. Now, if you want to learn more about how to set up the meter as far as like time and date, and perhaps you want to do sample averaging, then watch this video. It goes into greater detail about the fine details of this meter. But for now, I'm simply going to show you how to select the species and then how to take a measurement, and then how to get the data from the meter onto your computer. All right, from the main home screen, press the Run button. And then to select your species, press the Setup button. To select the species, you're going to want to press Up through the menu. And you'll have a screen that will say Custom Measurement. If you want to measure in CCI units, change that to No. If you want chlorophyll concentration or SPAD units, click Yes. To change it, click the Edit button, and then press Up or Down. With the Yes highlighted, press the right arrow button, and from here it'll give you a list of all the different species that are available. Here's a list of all the species that are available as of January 2025. All right, all those species are in alphabetical order in the meter.
So find the one that you're looking for. If you don't see the exact species you're looking for, find the species that's closest to the one that you're testing. If you still don't see the one you're looking for, there is a generic curve that's available and works with most species. Scroll up and down until you find the species you're looking for. We're going to do generic because this specific plant is not on this list. And then hit accept. It'll say down below the unit file saying generic. That means you're ready to start testing. So hit the exit button. And then push the measure button. Do know that chlorophyll amounts are different for different species. With the proper species selected, it's time to take a measurement. It's going to ask you to hold down the sensor and wait for it to calibrate. So use your thumb and push the arm down and hold it down until it says it's done calibrating. It'll say calibrate OK and then release arm. Then if you do have data stored on this device, it'll ask you what you want to do with that data. Whether you want to overwrite, whether you want to append to it, or if you want to cancel. In this case, we're going to overwrite, so we can start off fresh. And then it's ready to start taking measurements. It's typically a good idea to be consistent in your measurement. So make sure you're measuring the same leaf in the same area from day to day. For this example, we're going to take the third leaf from the top, and we're going to measure it on the medius part of the leaf, away from as much of the leaf structure as we can possibly get. We're going to hold it down. It'll say busy, it'll take a measurement, and it'll say done. Then it'll display the amount of chlorophyll in there, and you're ready to take your next measurement. As I mentioned earlier, there is a video that goes into detail about how to do sample averaging if you want to average the samples of the leaves of your plant. That's in the description below. If the leaf is too small and doesn't cover the sample area, you can always use those sensor reducers that I mentioned previously that are found in the kit. If the sample is too small or the leaf is too thick, keep in mind you could get inaccurate measurements or an insufficient light error. After you're done taking measurements on your device, it's time to put them on the computer. All right, so we got our computer, and pretty much this is going to work exactly like a USB thumb drive. So grab your USB cable, plug it in the computer, plug it into the meter. With it plugged in, turn on the meter. And you can do that by pressing the power button in the bottom right corner. It's going to take a second for it to load. And once it's done, you're going to press the data button, the one in the middle. And then it should pop up on your computer. If you don't see it pop up, you might need to go searching for it. But it should just pop up. However your flash drives typically work when you plug them into your computer, it'll do exactly the same thing. When it pops up, you're going to see a big list of files. This is where you're going to have all the species profiles. So as you look through these files, you'll see a bunch of table files or tab files. Those are all the species files. If you ever need to add more crops to your meter, then this is how you would do it. You just copy those files and put it on this device. So as you're looking through these files, you'll notice that one is different than the others. It's going to be a CSV file, and so you can either open it in Excel or you can open it in WordPad or whatever your spreadsheet is of choice. In this example, I'm just going to open it with WordPad. It's going to have it all separated in that comma separated value style. So it's going to tell you the sample number, it's going to tell you the time, it's going to tell you the date, and it's going to tell you the measurement or whatever units you measured it in. So if you did chard or whether you did lettuce, it's going to tell you what profile you're using. And then it's going to give you the chlorophyll readings or whatever reading it is that you measured it in. If you measured it in SPAD units, it's going to be in SPAD. If you measured it in CCI, it's going to be in CCI. You can copy this data and put it into your data analysis program of choice, and you can start doing your research there. To turn it off, just press the eject button. It's going to tell you to unplug the cable. And then, if you want, you can turn off the meter, and you're good to go. If you want to learn more about this meter, please see the manual linked in the description below. Thank you so much for watching. I hope this has answered any of the questions that you might have regarding the chlorophyll concentration meter. If you still have any questions, feel free to reach out to our customer support team. They're more than willing to help you find all the answers to your questions. If you want to learn more about the detailed setup on how to set time, date, GPS functionality, and sampling averaging, go ahead and click this video up here. If you want to learn more about the science behind this meter and how it works, consider clicking this video right here. Thank you so much for watching, and have a wonderful day, and happy measurements.